Hair transplant can be done in patients usually who are above 24 years of age. Patients younger than 24 years of age, it is usually advisable to go for medical therapies such as minoxidil, finasteride, and PRP. For patients who are above 24 years of age, hair transplant can be done safely. Patients who are older than 50 years of age, who have high blood pressure, uncontrolled diabetes, or heart disease, in such situations, hair transplant may not be done. In an otherwise healthy elderly individual, it can be done easily. It is a very safe surgery in experienced hands. To make a hair transplant look natural, there are a lot of factors which need to be considered. To start with, the hair length should start from around 7 to 10 centimeters from the space between the two eyebrows. It depends whether you have a lot of donor supply or not. If you have a limited area of baldness, the hair length can be started at around 7 centimeters also. If the baldness is too much, the hair length can be started at a higher point, maybe 8 centimeters or 9 centimeters. Number two thing to consider is that the point at which the hairline goes back and then comes forward should be right above the edge of the eye. Then the hairline is drawn, it should be in a zigzag manner, it should never be in a straight line. If it is made in a zigzag manner, it appears more natural. Then the other thing to be considered is that the angle and the direction of the hair should appear natural. The direction of hair should converge more towards the center, so that the center or the frontal tuft appears dense. The angles mean that the angle of the hair with the scalp should be natural. In the front, the hair angles are more flatter. On the top of the head, they are at around 30 to 45 degrees of angle. On the sides, that is these temporal triangles, in these areas, the hair are even flatter, almost at a 5 degree angle. Then the other thing to be considered is the distribution of follicular units. Follicular units contain 1, 2 or 3 hair depending on the areas where they are extracted from. If the 1 haired follicular units are placed in the front, 2 haired follicular units are placed in this area and 3 haired follicular units are placed in the central area, in that situation the hair transplant looks the best. It gives you the good dense results that you want. And it appears natural as well. The duration of a hair transplant surgery varies usually from 6 hours to 12 hours. If there are about 1000 or 1500 grafts that are to be transplanted, the surgery may end in around 6 hours. If there are around 3000 grafts, it may take around 10 hours. Then the downtime of the surgery is not that much. You can almost immediately resume your daily activities after the surgery. The only thing that restricts the mobility of the patients is that they have to wear a surgical cap for around 7 to 10 days. So people who are in public dealing businesses may want to take a leave of around 1 week after the surgery. But other people who are working from home or who are working on a computer need not take any leaves after the surgery. Pain with hair transplant used to be a major issue when people used to get FUT or the strip method done. With FUE, the pain is very minimal. You will feel some pain while local anesthesia is being administered. That means there will be a few injections which will be given on the scalp to make that area numb. After that, the surgery is relatively comfortable. You will not be able to feel anything. You can either sleep or listen to music. It will not be much of a problem. After the surgery also, the pain is usually minimal. Very few patients require some painkillers for one or 2 days at the max. After that, it is relatively painless. With FUT, that is the strip method, the donor area used to be the backside of the head only. With FUE, that is the newer method, the hair can be taken from the backside of your head, may be taken from below your jawline as well, can be taken from your chest also, and other body hair can also be used for performing a hair transplant. Not many preoperative preparations are needed for performing a hair transplant. The only thing that needs to be considered is whether the patient is on any medicines or not. if the patient has any uncontrolled disease like diabetes or high blood pressure. Also, one important factor in performing a hair transplant is that the patient should not be a smoker. Ideally, you should leave smoking at least 2 weeks before the surgery so as to get best results. If you are an occasional smoker, it may not be much of a problem. Alcohol usually needs to be stopped to reduce any side effects at around 1 week before the surgery. Cost of hair transplant primarily depends on the number of grafts that are to be used in the recipient area. Also, the second factor in deciding the cost of hair transplant is the area from which the hair are being taken out. In typical cases, the hair which are to be taken out from this area are relatively cheaper. The hair which are to be taken from beard are slightly more expensive. How you should choose a hair transplant surgeon is a very important question in the minds of patients. What all you should consider is, number one, you should consider the qualifications of the surgeon. The doctor should be either a qualified dermatologist or a qualified plastic surgeon. The doctor should have performed a lot of surgeries. You should be able to see the results of the patients. You should be able to meet the patients in person also. You should analyze the results for density, for the natural appearance of hair transplant results, as well as the overall look. Hair transplantation can also be performed in women, especially in those women who have not responded adequately to the medical therapy or PRP and who have bald patches on the top of their scalp. The donor area should be sufficient, that is, the area on the back side of the head should have enough hair for the transplantation to be done. Hair transplant in scarring alopecia can give very good results, provided it is done properly. The scarring alopecia may have been due to a trauma or a burn. In those situations, hair transplant is fairly simple. It is similar to the usual hair transplant. But in situations where scarring alopecia has occurred due to a disease such as DALE or FPP, in such situations, hair transplantation is performed with even more caution. The reason being that the disease can destroy the transplanted hair also. So it is done in three steps. Number one step is to do a skin biopsy and do a clinical examination to rule out that the disease is not progressive anymore. Number two step is to do a small test hair area of hair transplantation. Specifically, around 100 hair are transplanted in the recipient area. They are tested and observed over a period of the next 6 months. If the growth is satisfactory and the disease does not appear to be progressive, a full-scale hair transplant may be performed. For eyebrow transplantation, hair are usually taken from the lower aspect of the backside of the scalp, where the hair are usually thinner, which leads to a natural result in eyebrow transplantation. The other thing to be taken into consideration in eyebrow transplant is that the angles should be very natural. The angles on the medial side, that is the side towards the nose, tend to be more vertical, then the hair tend to become more horizontal as we progress towards the ears.
Please subscribe to our channel, and for more such videos and information, please click on the bell icon. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.